We got a dog now.
We just got invited by a local that passed by.
Hello and welcome to the 10th episode, where we drive through Turkish Kurdistan to the Georgian border, get invited by locals and meet fellow travelers.
An apple?
We're having a quick lunch break on the side of the road. We just got invited by a local that passed by. It's actually his house there. Yeah, the red house in the distance, it's his house. So he said we should stop by and have a coffee with him. We just met Mehmet and his three friends that also called Mehmet.
Yeah, that was fun.
Some of his co-workers. It was really nice. They invited us for coffee and baklava. Thank you so much for it.
Yeah, thank you very much. So if you see the video, then we really, really are grateful that you stopped by and invited us to your place. Very
really nice.
Nice.
Thank you.
We're just crossing the city and just realized that neither our Google Maps nor the Garmin are working. So all the satellite GPS signals are blocked in this street, and we are guessing it's because left to us there's a big military area.
In the south, and especially in the southeast of Turkey, there are a lot of military checkpoints along the roads. Every village or town has one at the entrance and at the exit of the town. Also, on all major roads connecting cities, there are military camps and checkpoints on the road, so they can lock down the whole country or the whole region within minutes.
That's the soundtrack for tonight.
Thank you.
Hola. Hola.
Spots next to Bingöl at the river and are now heading towards the border of Georgia. I'm not sure if we're going to make it today, but plan is to cross into Georgia today or tomorrow. You, my friend, you're going to go. No, you don't like it. I think you're better here. We got a dog now.
You cannot come with us, I'm sorry. We are going to find your home.
Sorry. Sorry, buddy. Not my intention.
We dropped off the dog at the restaurant next door. And they said the mother is going to come, they know them. And now we're going to head towards
Erzurum.
Georgia.
Erzurum. First Erzurum, and then we will see if we continue or we do that border crossing tomorrow.
So you got the door. You're not here anymore.
Just walked by and bought some lama june pide, and they gave us some salad with it. We will just go out of the city and have some lunch.
We actually thought we got vegetarian pide with cheese, but it turns out cheese also means meat. Paradise for you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
this was before a town in the valley. Now it's an artificial lake.
Yeah, the satellite maps show no lake.
On the last leg to the Georgian border, we met Chris and his three daughters. They are traveling by bike since 1.5 years. They covered whole Europe and are now on the way to India. It was really inspiring to see them as a small family traveling by bike. I have a huge respect for the girls, riding bicycles weighing 20 to 25 kilos and still having energy to run around, explore the surroundings, after they drove 60 to 80 k's every day. We will link their Instagram in our description, so go over and check them out.
Today's home office. Because it's actually snowing a little bit. We are currently staying on a small island in a lake close to the Georgian border. We are here at 2000 meters altitude. The weather is really not that great. We have 5 degrees. It's pretty windy and we even had some snow this morning. We spent the whole day inside the car editing and organizing stuff. Now it's time to find a new place to camp because the spot where we are is too exposed, is too windy, the tent is rattling the whole time, so we try to find something that's a little bit more protected. It's not that easy on this island. There are a couple of trees here, so we might going to try to drive here and hopefully we can sleep in the tent and we don't need to sleep down. It's just more comfortable up. It's way calmer over here. The trees protect us from the wind. We're going to make dinner and then watch a movie. Tomorrow in the morning we want to get an early start and drive to the border of Georgia and hopefully cross.
But this is a story for next time.